as doctors continue to warn the system's overwhelmed.
It's like a war zone. We're in a war with very limited resources.
And a scramble to build makeshift morgues and field hospitals. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo to NBC's Lester Holt.
I hope this whole facility, Lester, stays empty.
I believe that's going to be the case.
The numbers don't say that's going to be the case.
In California, it's all hands on deck.
Every minute is a minute lost.
A dire warning from officials. Los Angeles is just days away from the kind of crisis engulfing New York. This weekend, the USNS Mercy is expected to open, providing much-needed support to non-COVID-19 patients.
As impressive as the ship is, it represents only a fraction.
People are dying.
Of the city's needs, it has 80 ICU beds. LA officials estimate they need 3,000.
New Orleans, too, emerging as a hotspot in the pandemic. NBC's Blaine Alexander.
Now, with the cases here in Louisiana growing faster than anywhere else in the world, the reality is that there are just not enough tests to confirm every case.
In Miami, a mandatory curfew. Orders to stay off the streets from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m.
It is growing quickly. I mean, every time I go into work, we have at least a few more cases.
Now there's a statewide ban on vacation rentals, in addition to a mandatory two-week quarantine for anyone arriving from Louisiana and New York. In Rhode Island, police stopping cars with New York plates.
Right now, we have a pinpointed...
People are dying.
We need to be very serious. And that risk is called New York City.
That was NBC's Erin McLaughlin reporting.
And also this morning, hospitals across the country should hopefully be getting more ventilators after President Trump, under pressure, officially invoked a little-used power of the presidency to get a major automaker to pitch in. But that automaker says they were already on it. NBC's Kelly O'Donnell is at the White House with the very latest on that. Kelly, good morning to you.
Good morning, Kristen. Despite the president's reluctance early on, he is now using the federal government's power to manufacture more ventilators and buy more where available over the next 3 months. A tight timeline given the number of serious illnesses from coronavirus continues to rise in hotspots around the country.
President Trump moved from talk to action on forced manufacturing of medical equipment.
Ventilators are a big deal.
After 9 days of discussing the Defense Production Act powers, Friday, the president finally used it when he says negotiations with General Motors to build ventilators hit a roadblock.
We didn't want to play games. If they don't treat you right, I don't call.
In a remarkable turnaround, the president, who had insisted last week, the federal government is not the nation's shipping clerk.
We have to get these people on board. We're not looking to get into a big deal on price.
Now says the U.S. government can order ventilators to supply states and allies.
If we do not need them, that would be wonderful. We can help a lot of great people all over the world. We can help them live.
Bristling at demands and complaints from some governors, Mr. Trump made known his expectations.
I want them to be appreciative.
As the virus spreads and deaths climb, the president backed off his push to ease restrictions by Easter Sunday, saying he will consult medical experts.
Life, then it's your safety. And if we need more time, they're not going to have a problem waiting it out.
The president was surrounded by Republican leaders as he signed the largest relief package in U.S. history. Democrats were not invited to attend.
I want to thank Republicans and Democrats.
Today, President Trump heads to Norfolk, Virginia to send off a Navy hospital ship. NBC's Courtney Kuby.
The next time the USNS Comfort is scheduled to be in port is in New York City. The 1,000 beds on this hospital ship will ease some of the burden on New York City's overwhelmed hospital system.
It sends a signal when the president is able to go there and say thank you.
And President Trump will return to the White House after...
Most of you.